In this video, we are going to see about contact lenses. Contact lenses are nothing but artificial device whose front surface substitutes the anterior surface of the cornea. If you think, imagine this as a cornea, the contact lenses covers just in front of the anterior surface of the cornea. Okay, for what uses we are using contact lenses? This is because to correct the refractive error and to correct the irregularities of the front surface of the cornea. For both of this, we are using contact lenses. Now, we would see the types of contact lenses based on the nature of material. Based on the nature of the material, it is classified into three types: hard lenses, rigid gas permeable lenses, and soft lenses. In hard lenses, first in all these three types, we have to see based on four headings. One is on what material it is made, then the features of this lens, and what is the diameter of the lens, and advantages and disadvantages. In these four headings we are going to see. In hard lenses, which is made up of PMMA, polymethyl metha acrylate, and rigid gas permeable lens, it is made up of silicone acrylate, which is PMMA plus silicone. And soft lenses, it is made up of hydroxy ethyl methyl acrylate, that is HEMA. In rigid gas permeable lenses, mostly used silicone acrylate, in some cases cellulose acetate butyrate, it is also used. What are the features of the hard lenses? It is high optical quality lens, lightweight, non-toxic, durable and cheap, but it is not used now because this hard lenses are impermeable to oxygen. Okay, impermeable to oxygen means cornea gets its main nutrition supply from air, that is oxygen and aqueous humor. So it is impermeable to oxygen, so cornea doesn't get any nutrition and oxygen supply. So these lenses are not used now. It is also hard, so it causes corneal erosions and abrasions. Then hydrophobic, no, so it resists sweating, and a stable tear film is formed over that lens. It resists sweating, so a tear film covers that hard lenses. This is also the disadvantage of hard lenses, so it is not used now. Then rigid gas permeable lenses, it is a silicone acrylate lens. It is also made up of cellulose acetate butyrate, as I mentioned earlier. It is hard but permeable to oxygen. So it is also called as semi-soft lenses. It is used mostly now. Then comes the soft lenses. Soft lenses, here it is larger than the corneal diameter. That is 1 to 2 mm larger than the corneal diameter. What are the advantages? Means it is soft and oxygen permeable, most comfortable and well tolerated lens. It is used commonly. Disadvantages means here proteinaceous deposits easily gets deposited because it is larger and longer than the corneal diameter. Okay. Then problem of wettability, it easily gets wet, whereas hard lenses is resist wetting like that. Here it is of a limited life because it easily gets cracked, and inferior optical quality compared to hard lenses, it has an inferior optical quality. Corneal infections are more common, and it can't correct astigmatism greater than 2 diopter. These are the disadvantages of soft lenses. But it is oxygen permeable, so it can be used comfortably. Then what are the parts and curves of the contact lenses? Here the maximum distance between the two edges of the contact lens is called as overall diameter, and the diameter within the optic zone where the rays passes through this center of the contact lens is called as optic zone diameter. This is overall diameter and optic zone diameter, two diameter we have to study. Then in curves wise, we are going to see about posterior and anterior curves. Central posterior curve or base curve. Here the posterior and anterior regions are divided into three, like central, intermediate and peripheral. In posterior, only central is present and peripheral is present. Central posterior curve or base curve. Then in peripheral curve, we have intermediate posterior curve and peripheral posterior curve. Together is called as peripheral curve. Okay. Intermediate peripheral curve and this peripheral part of the posterior curve together called as peripheral curve. In anterior, we have central anterior curve, which is also called as front curve, then intermediate anterior curve and peripheral anterior curve. In anterior, we have three parts. In posterior, the intermediate and peripheral posterior curve is fused to form as a posterior curve. Then edges. Edges means the posterior part of the contact lens and the anterior curves of the contact lens are fused to form the edge. In both sides we have the edges. Then power of the lens. Power of the lens, according to their needs, we are changing the power of the lens. And mostly power of the lens determined by the central anterior curve, that is front curve, determines the power of the lens. Vertex point in the posterior shows the power of the lens. Then thickness of the lens. Thickness of the lens, it is between the anterior and the posterior curve, space between the anterior and the posterior curve. Then tint. Tint means color of the contact lenses. Now in various colors they are using for different purposes. For actors they are using different colors. And to cover the, in case of albinism, to prevent photophobia, different colored contact lenses are used. Then indication for contact lens. There are about 7 indications. Optical indication, therapeutic indication, preventive indication, diagnostic indication, operative, cosmetic and occupational. Here optical means based on different optical conditions like refractive error, high myopia, keratoconus, irregular astigmatism, unilateral aphakia and anisometropia. Then therapeutic indication, in different therapeutic indications of different parts of the eye like cornea, iris, and certain conditions like glaucoma, amblyopia and bandage contact lenses. In all these therapeutic indication, contact lenses are used. Then preventive indication, for prevention of simpliperon and restoration of fornices in chemical burns, exposure keratitis and trichiasis. In these conditions, contact lenses are used. Then diagnostic purpose like electroretinogram, gonioscopy, fundus examination, fundus photography and Goldman's three-mirror examination. In all these, they have used contact lens. Then operative indication, gonioscopy operation for congenital glaucoma, vitrectomy, intraocular photocoagulation. Then cosmetic and occupational based on here. I said no in actors, pilots, sportsmen. And in cosmetic condition, corneal scars, ptosis, cosmetic scleral lesions in thysis bulbae, like that. Last, contraindications. Contraindications mainly on the chronic conditions like dacrocystitis, conjunctivitis and blepharitis. In all these chronic dacrocystitis, conjunctivitis and blepharitis, it should not be used. Then mental incompetence patients, they are not allowed to use this. Then dry eye patients, then corneal dystrophy and degeneration, recurrent infection like episcleritis, scleritis and iridocyclitis. In all these conditions, contact lenses are contraindicated. What are the advantages of these contact lenses? Contact lenses provide normal field of vision compared to the spectacles. Then it corrects irregular astigmatism. Aberrations associated with spectacles are eliminated. Binocular vision is retained even in high magnification. Then rain and fog do not condense. In case of spectacles, rain and fog condense the glasses. Here it do not condense it. Then cosmetically more acceptable than spectacles, because spectacles means you have to wear, and in different places it is cosmetically not acceptable. The principles of fitting and care of lenses, it should be regularly cleaned, because infections are more common in contact lens users, and taking care of these lenses is very important. Then frequent changing of contact lenses, because in certain contact lenses the lifetime is about 1 week or 1 month, like that we have to change the contact lens. Contact lens infections are more common, like a corneal ulcer and other more severe infections can occur. So care must be taken while fitting, and in old age it is not recommended, because for them it is difficult to fit clean and like that. So these are the principles of fitting and care of lenses. Thank you.